A very good morning and Om Shanti to all of you listeners. Welcome back to your own channel, See the Soul, the Truth Lies Within. Today is 258th day of Octopodal Blessing, and there's a learning in this blessing too. So let's go ahead, let's find out what does Baba have to say. Baba says, may you be an embodiment of authority and benefit many souls with the intoxication of your most elevated position. Now, when a person remembers his position or post or accomplishments or qualification, they have certain kind of intoxication about it. They speak from authority. Whenever they say something, they say, I have learned this, I have an experience about this, and they speak from authority. So here, what kind of authority is God trying to talk about? Let's explore that. Baba says, we are the children of the Almighty Authority, Supreme God Father. Do we remember that throughout the day? If we don't, then our karmas are getting wrong. We are becoming more sinful. If we remember that we are children of God, then our karmas will be changing. And karmas change as per the seed which you put. And the seed which you put is your thoughts. So thoughts, words and actions affect our karmas. And when we remember that we are the children of God the Father, then our thoughts change. They are more pure, or they are getting purer day by day. And our words and actions also change. And when we remember even for a second that we are God's children, our karmas are pure. When we forget that we are God's children, or we remember that we are some worldly people, then our karmas become a little maligned and they become a little impure. So God says, we are the children of the Almighty Authority. This is the most elevated position. Think about it. Is there any other position? Somebody says, I'm the child of the Prime Minister of so-and-so country. I'm the child of so-and-so person, or a minister, or an army person, or a business person. Does it have an effect? Worldly people might be getting affected out of it. But if you think of yourself as God's child, which all of us are, which we don't remember throughout the day actually, then our thought will change. Just like the child of a king, if he knows that he's a king's child, then his talking, his speaking, his karmas, his getting up, his sleeping, his eating mannerism, everything will be royal, won't it be? The way he gets up, the way he walks, the way he talks, the way she dresses up, everything will be changed. Here, if you think that you're the child of God, then you'll be using what? You'll be using the knowledge which God has given. You'll be using the qualities, the virtues. You'll be using humility. You'll be using patience. You'll be using acceptance. You'll be using tolerance. You'll be using royal thoughts. You'll be using thoughts of a visionary. You'll be thinking about everybody's benefit. And many more qualities will be there within you. But is there any comparison of this with any other person in the world? No. They might be a person of a prime minister's family, but you are more royal than anybody else if you think about it, thinking that you're God's child. So your thoughts will be changing, your tolerance will be more, you'll be having more visionary thoughts, and you'll be more powerful. So that is what God wants us to do. He wants us to change our thought patterns. Then Baba says, by being an embodiment of this authority, you can benefit any soul. Why? Because if you act in a royal way, royal doesn't mean egoistic. Royal means royal thoughts, pure thoughts, elevated thoughts towards everybody. Then that will affect other people also. Think about yourself as the head of the family. If you have got royal thoughts, royal behavior, virtuous behavior, then automatically everybody around you, your own family members, will get affected. But if you think from the point of view of how much money you have, what positions you have, what posts you have, where you're coming from in a worldly way, then you'll showcase ego, and your children, your family members will also start accepting that as the reality, whereas that is not a reality, because that is a limited reality. The unlimited reality that is that we are all children of God, and when we think about that unlimited reality and act upon that, then our karmas will be more and more purer and refined and more royal. So then God says, those who constantly have this intoxication receive the fortune of the kingdom for all time. Constantly have this authority. Which authority? That I am God's child, supreme authority's child, and the world will bow down to you. Why? Because our karmas will be so refined and defined in a very, very definitive manner. Why? Because we'll be thinking thoughts which are very pure and elevated. Godly virtues, godly qualities, godly powers will be exhibited through our karmas, through our words, through our actions, and then we are not sinning. But if you're thinking in a worldly manner, then obviously there's some kind of ego, jealousy, some form of sinful behavior, sinful thoughts, and obviously you'll be sorry at certain point of time. You'll have to bow down in front of others because you're sorry for that wrong karma. So then God says, you cannot bow down in front of anyone if you follow godly dictates, if you think that you're God's child. So I leave you with this beautiful blessing. And if you think what has been spoken over here is correct, and if you want to follow it, do put your comments down. It's not an easy task because we have the habit of thinking something else. Now suddenly we have to think we are God's child, and how we have to think is a behavioral pattern change which needs to be brought about over a period of time. But that is what we do in meditation. We think that we are God's children, and we think how we need to think, how we need to speak, how we need to act, because the whole world is watching. So I leave you with this beautiful word, and have a blessed day, stay safe, and enjoy the festivities. Om Shanti.